Local doctors say that they have a new weapon in the fight against cancer, herpes. That's right. WLKY's Jennifer Bayless examines how doctors are using the virus to attack melanoma.
It's been a roller coaster of a ride.
A ride that has changed the course of his life. It started in February. Trinity High School teacher Stephen Tompkins says he found a lump in his groin area that started out as an itch.
I thought it was a hernia, so I went to my general doctor and asked him, and so in examining me, he said that's not a hernia, it's a lipoma.
Tompkins says his general surgeon found another lump that turned out to be cancer.
Metastatic melanoma, stage 3B.
Tompkins and his wife decided the best treatment was a clinical trial called T-VEC, using a form of the herpes virus. It's offered by Kentucky One Health, the James Graham Brown Cancer Center, and University of Louisville researcher Dr. Jason Chesney.
It's a genetically engineered virus that will selectively kill cancer cells, not cause oral herpes, but induce, at the same time, induce the immune system to fight the cancer.
The trial has led to several discoveries, including an improved immune system in patients.
Immune therapies will activate your body's own immune system to go after the cancer, and your immune system stays there, and it continues to fight the cancer for years to come.
I had a place on my arm, under my arm.
Brandenburg farmer Charles Jenkins is fighting his second bout of melanoma. He had 6 spots when he started the T-VEC clinical trial a year ago.
All the internal spots are gone, and the tumor in my arm is practically gone.
The side effects are minimal. Some experience a fever and chills, while others report nothing other than soreness at the injection site.
To get the results this morning to say, hey, there's nothing. Your scans were great. It's still in one spot. You know, that's very exciting.
I suspect in 5 years we're going to see at least a 33% reduction in death rates. I think in 20 years we're going to see probably an 80% reduction. And by the time our children are in their 60s, when the peak incidence of cancer occurs, we're going to be able to cure the vast majority of patients who develop cancer.
While they are injecting the herpes virus, Dr. Chesney says this treatment does not cause cold sores or the virus. For information on how to join this clinical trial, go to WLKY.com. Jennifer Bayless, WLKY News.